Praise the Lord and God bless you. You are in tune with the Georgia God Chasers. That's right, the Georgia God Chasers. And we are emanating live from the city of Alpharetta, Georgia. The reason why I'm smiling, and you know, when you're doing live broadcasts, you can expect anything. It's sort of informal. We don't have our stage or our sound in our studio. I'm coming live from and through a webcam. So sometimes before coming on, you have to expect the unexpected. And sometimes while you're broadcasting, you have to expect the unexpected. But I'm excited that you took the time out of your busy schedule to come and hear what thus saith the Lord. Truly, there is a word from God for your life. Amen. Amen. God is good and his mercy endureth forever. I want to just start off this broadcast with a word of prayer. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you right now for all that you've done and all that you are going to do in the lives of your people that are listening and watching this broadcast on today. Surely, Lord, without you, we could do nothing. God, we could have nothing. We could not be nothing. And because of your mercies, we have not been consumed. Great is thy faithfulness. Amen. God is doing so much. We are revamping our website. We are, you know, just sending updates through our Twitter page. We're working on our Facebook page because we realize that God has a blessing to and for his people. The purpose of this online Bible study broadcast is not just for those who don't really know the Word of God, but it's to stir up your pure minds for those who do know the Word of God. Each and every one of us, no matter who we are or where we are, we need to hear a word from God. And through the Word of God comes the Word of God. And yes, it is the Word of the Lord that will change your very life and enlighten your soul. So never think that I am who I am in God and I don't need the word. And never think that because I really don't know the word of God that I'm nothing. Amen. For it is the will of God that we all hear the word of God, understand the word of God, and grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. If you would like to write us, I want you to address all correspondence to not the Catch a Hold of Faith Deliverance Broadcast. That's for television. That slipped. But the Catch a Hold of Faith Deliverance Broadcast will be on television. Oops. But we let it out anyway. And to God be the glory. But this is the Georgia God Chasers, and it is a part of Sandra Wilson Ministries Incorporated. So address those correspondence letters to Post Office Box 5252, Alpharetta, Georgia, 30023. Amen. So we have nothing to hide, but sometimes you want to keep a little bit of things under wraps. So I guess God wanted me to say it, so I said it. Yes, we're going to do television. Amen. We have signed contracts for television. And I will tell you this, you don't need a lot of people when God is with you. The Bible says that one of you shall chase 1,000 and two shall put 10,000 to flight. So I'm excited. I'm excited. I heard someone say on a Facebook platform, you know, you don't have to go around trying to do what everyone else is doing or be where everyone else is. In so many words, you just need to do what God called you to do. You need to be in the right place and in the right time for your miracle. I would rather be in the right place and at the right time to receive of God than to be somewhere I'm not called to be yet. Amen. That is so important. The Bible says when you come into a room, there will be presence of, I would say there will be people that may be greater than you in ministry. They are, I will always say this, they are the forerunners in the gospel. We're not supposed to get angry at the ones that God sends ahead of us. They're sent ahead of us to show us that, you know what? Yes, this gospel will be preached in all the world. But sometimes on the road to destiny, the Bible says you have to learn to sit down in the lower place until you're bidden to come up higher. Now, your coming up higher may be in the north platform. Someone else's coming up higher may be in the south platform. Someone may be in the east or west. But I want you to know, when God is in it, oh my God, when God is in the building, as that song says, I will tell you, things begin to happen. God is an awesome, awesome, awesome God. And I want you to learn to just wait on the Lord and be of good courage. I want you to know God will strengthen your heart. The Bible says, wait, I say, on the Lord. Oh Lord, our God, how excellent is thy name. Sometimes you just got to give him the praise. Sometimes you just got to worship. And all the time, amen, out of our mouths, my God, we ought to just be giving up the praise. Why? Because God said, oh, give thanks unto the Lord. He said that in the word. Because what? He is good, and his mercy endureth forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he hath redeemed out of the hands of the enemy. Many of you have callings of God on your life, and you've been waiting on a season. My God, I wasn't supposed to go this way. But let me say this. In every season, something happens. Something happens in the summer. You know that it's summer. Something happens in the spring. The flowers begin to bloom. Something happens in the fall. The leaves fall off the tree. And something happens in the winter, and it gets cold. What season are you in? And let me tell you something about seasons. Man don't get to control. I feel God. Man does not get to control your seasons. God gets to control the seasons. Even as he controls the natural season, God controls your season. My God, he controls when your promotion that comes not from the east or west. He controls whether you can be where you are right now and when he can take you out of obscurity, where the whole world will know not just your name, but the name that is above every name. And at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. Every tongue shall confess that Jesus is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. I want to go quickly into the Word of God because I feel the supernatural anointing of God. I felt the presence of God when I woke up this morning. I just started preaching to whoever I saw. My God, it might have been my children, but I went to just saying what thus saith the Lord. Let's go to the book of Psalms, the 91st chapter, and let's begin at the first verse. It reads on this wise. To those of you who are new Georgia God chasers and you don't know about the Word of God, if you look in the front of your book, you'll see Psalms, P-S-A-L-M-S. That's what it's spelled. That's how it's spelled. Psalms. Amen. It says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I'm trying my best not to lose it, but I feel the presence of God. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In him will I trust. Now, this is the verse that I want you to just remember. I want you to jump up, shout, and scream. If I'm talking to you, you ain't got to be undignified. But I, you know how I know. We do. When we're in a place that we can't really jump up and scream, we feel the fire of God in our soul. And we just, that's how it gets good sometimes. Listen, surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the what? The noisome pestilence. And under his wings shalt thou trust. I'm going to read the whole thing, but we're going to go back to Shirley. Listen what he said. He shall cover. Who shall cover? God shall cover you with his feathers. And under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be your shield and your buckler. My God, thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day. God is talking to somebody. My God, I know he's talking to me. Nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth, my God, at noonday. Listen, he said, 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand. Could you imagine that? But it shall not come nigh thee. I don't care what somebody's plans is. The Bible says no weapon formed against you shall prosper. And every tongue, I'll tell you, every tongue that rises against you in judgment, my God, your inheritance is among those that are sanctified. You will condemn it. The word of the Lord will condemn it. Woo, my God, only, hear me in the Holy Ghost. The Bible says, only with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. People setting traps for you, jealous of the anointing of God on your life. You didn't do nothing but suffer. God said, if you suffer with me, you shall reign with me. How dare someone touches a child of the living God? My God. I told someone today, if you see a baby lion cub walking by itself, you better not touch that cub. If you see a baby bear that might have gotten loose from his mother, you better go the other way. Why? Because the mother ain't too far behind. And as a child of the living God, don't you know when you are a child of God and you're walking in the apostolic perfect will of the living God and you're doing the will of God, my God, he that touches you touches God. Don't you know God watches over his word to perform it? You have no business being afraid of the arrow that flies by day. My God, God said, the sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord that keepeth thee, he shall preserve thy soul. He shall preserve your going out. He shall preserve your coming in from this time forth, even forevermore. This scripture is for you today because God has been watching you since the beginning of time, and his word is over your life. You've been suffering. You've been going through. People see the glory, but they don't know your story. Everybody's all fascinated because you can preach, you can pray, you can prophesy, but they don't see the tears that you shed. They don't see the things that you had to go through before you get to where you are right now. They don't see the struggles. Oh, she can preach. My God, he can preach. But he, Shy, that dwells in the secret place of the Most High. My God, you're going to abide. God got his eyes on you. And I will tell you what, the witch and the warlock knows it. And they want to. But my God, they could not curse Israel. And they will not, shall not come nigh thee. Can we finish, my God? And let me tell you why. He said, only with thine eyes shalt thou behold. God said, I'm going to let you see their demise. My God, I'm going to let you see their demise with your eyes. God said, only with your eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Now, I know I'm going to touch somebody in the Holy Ghost right now. But every person that has dug a ditch for you to fall in, they're sitting back there saying, aha, I got them right where I want. But surely, God said, I'm going to deliver you from the snare of the fowler and the noisome pestilence. Got you in a trap. Got you right where they want. Won't turn you loose. Happy you lost your church. Happy you lost your ministry. Happy that things ain't going right in your ministry. Happy because people left. My God, the ones that's in there is the one that's causing confusion. And then they sit up there and they come before you. Well, you know, Pastor, the Lord is going to stop it. I'll bind your evil spirit. My God, you ought to call it like you see it. Sometimes you're sitting there and you don't want to say nothing. You know. God said, you know who they are. That's the house of the Lord. God put you in charge of the house of the Lord. How dare you let a devil come up in your house and run it? I know one thing, your name and your address where you live at, you ain't gonna let, and excuse the ain't, but you're not gonna let nobody come to your house, not where I live, and tell me what to do. So you mean to tell me God's going to put me in charge of his house? And you going to act like you want? You going to do like? Not so. My God, even as we call those things, as my God, we call those things that be not as though they were. You better get the house of God in order. God puts you in charge. You better stand flat footed. And tell the devil like it is. Because let me tell you something. When one leaves, God will send 10. When 10 leaves, I'll send 20. One of you shall chase 1,000. My God, can we get back to the word? And the reason why God is going to fight for some of you, I'm not saying all of you, but the reason, you know who you are that's living for God. You know you're not playing with God. You know you ain't got no time for, don't come to me with no crazy foolishness. I ain't got time to hear it. Oh, you so deep. Oh, God's just using her. She's just so deep. Deep, call it, I will shine. Call it unto deep. My God. I feel the presence of God. You don't got time to play. The work that you're doing now will determine whether you have a seat in the kingdom. The prophecies you prophesy will determine whether you have a seat in the kingdom. The devils that you cast out and don't care if they get mad. Honey, it will determine whether you have a seat in the kingdom of God. It's not about the honorariums. It's not about the offerings. It's not about how many times you get to go on the road. Every time you go on that road, everything is being recorded. When you get in the hotel rooms, it's being recorded. Who you go in the hotel rooms with, it's being recorded. I will tell you, the day is now here. That the things that are done in the dark, it's going to be coming to light. You're going to wonder how the world know what you've been doing. Because God's going to pull the cover off of it. And this broadcast is not to tell you that he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High. But you better get yourself together. My God. God's not playing. This is an apostolic season. What you talking about? This is the apostolic season. I'm Baptist. Jesus said, behold, I give unto you power. Denominations ain't up in that. He said, behold, I give unto you power to tread upon serpents and tread upon scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. and nothing shall by any means hurt you. And I'm telling you, if you have the power of God in you and you can command the devil to leave the region, rejoice not that the spirits are subject unto you. The Bible says rejoice because your name is written on high. When I say we are in an apostolic season, God is going to promote some people. Their ministries will quickly come into fruition. And I'll tell you, the ones that shucking and jiving, flipping and flopping, hitting and missing, oh my God, God's going to replace you. He said, you know what? I'd rather you be hot or cold. He said, lukewarm, I will spew you out of my mouth. How dare you come into the kingdom of God after all that you suffered to get where you are, and you step out of place as if God didn't bless you in the city, if he didn't bless you in the field, if he didn't bless your basket in your store, if he didn't bless your coming in and your going out from this time forevermore. You better hold on to Deuteronomy 28 like some of you are holding on to your checkbook. My God, the American Express card said don't leave home without it. You better not leave your house without the apostolic anointing of the Holy Ghost, because the enemy's assignment is to wipe you out, to cancel you before you even get to the next level. How dare you gloat? God told me to tell you. He said, tell them, don't you even think that you can wear my glory. My glory I will not give to no other. You can't wear glory. It does not fit you. My God, the heavens and the heavens of heaven can't even contain God. How dare you think you can wear glory? Oh, I preached, didn't I? Oh, did you see what happened in the service? Girl, didn't the Lord bless us? I mean, carrying on like it was by your power. It was by your hand that God promoted you. I didn't see you get up and die for the cross. You are not the death, burial, and resurrection. Humble yourself. Pride goes before a fall. Stop making people think that it's all about you. And the reason why you have what you have is because, you know what? I got favor. God is just with me. Oh, yes, Jesus. Amen. Sweet tea. I mean, sweet tea. The kind of tea where you go in the restaurant that you don't need no sugar. Sweet tea. This is not about you. It's about the kingdom of God. He told me to warn you. He said, tell them they cannot wear glory. They can't have my glory. I will not share it. And let me say this. The last person that said, I'm going to exalt myself above the stars. I want to be over you, God. Jesus said, I beheld Satan as lightning fall from heaven. I'll tell you what, you don't know me and I don't know you. And this platform is God's platform. Therefore, if I answer to anybody, it's the Holy Ghost. You better get yourself together. God said, I'm coming quickly. And my reward is with me, and I'm going to pay every man according to his work. Shelby, let me tell you, the Bible says, he that's holy, let him be holy still. He that's filthy, let him be filthy still. He that is just, let him be just still. And he that is righteous, let him be righteous still. I'll tell you, there will be a time where two will be in the field. One will be taken, the other will be left. Two the Bible says, will be grinding at the mill. One will be taken, the other will be left. Don't let God catch you with your work undone. We have the gospel, the gospel. You sing, you shout. The body of Christ is full of so many gifts, but gifts and calling of God are without repentance. I'm telling you, in this apostolic season of God's presence, and let me say what that means, that the power of God that was in the days of old, where devils were cast out in the name of Jesus, where the sick was healed in the name of Jesus, where blind eyes was opened in the name of Jesus, where the dead was raised in the name of Jesus, you are now in that era. And I will tell you, an evil and an adulterous generation, oh, they want to see the signs. But you know what? Guess what sign you're going to see? The sign that will distinguish between those who are real and those who are not. Those who have the fake and shake and those who have the real uppertake of the Holy Ghost. God is going to let there be a difference between holy and unholy. There is a sound. You can tell who it's in when that sound comes out of their mouth. It is the power of the living God. It means that person has been in the presence of God. They were spending time in the presence of God, and they were hearing the voice of the Lord. Let me tell you this. Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall you, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion. My God, not only the serpents and scorpions, but the lion. The devil may walk about as a roaring lion, seeking who he may devour. But God said, you will tread upon the lion and the adder, those snakes. My God, that's around the encampment of God's people. Those slithering demonic spirits that think they can hiss in the house of God, getting up, speaking in tongues that have nothing to do with the Holy Ghost. God sees you. I'll let you tread on them with my word. My God, he will let you tread on that adder. My God, the young lion and those dragon-like spirits. God said you'll trample them under your feet. Why? Because he has set his love upon me. Therefore, will I deliver him. I will set him on high because he has known my name. He shall call upon me and I will answer him. I will be with you, God says, in trouble. I will deliver you and honor you. Now listen to this last verse. He said, with long life will I satisfy him. And I'm going to show you my salvation. My God, let me say this in the Holy Ghost. And we're going to end this broadcast tonight because I want this word to resonate in your spirit and in your soul. These are the last days. You're seeing things that are coming upon the land that is not of God. Did not God say that the last days was coming? And that perilous times will come. Men will be lovers of themselves, proud boasters, blasphemers, lovers. Oh my God, they would go crazy. Lovers of pleasure more than lovers of God. You have been warned so many times. that it has been inscribed in the book. And before you go to bed on tonight, you need to ask yourself, is my name written in the Lamb's Book of Life? Only God knows whose name is surely written in the Lamb's Book of Life. I came to encourage you to keep walking in the will and the way of God, for God has not forgotten you. He told me to tell you, surely he shall deliver you. He sees that trap. He knows who it is. He knows their name, their address, their city and state. I bind that blackmailing spirit in the name of Jesus upon the face of this earth. And I cast that blackmailing demon spirit into dry places. I'm talking to somebody. Somebody think they got the goods on you. And because they think they got the goods on you, they can use that against you. And they feel it would tear your ministry up. But let me say this to you in the Holy Ghost. You have a way of an escape. The Bible says, I have no pleasure in the death of the wicked, but that the wicked turn from their evil ways. God said, if you sinned, you have an advocate with the Father. I don't care what spirit it is that you were caught up in. I want you to know that if you confess your sins, God is faithful and just to forgive you of your sins. And I want you to know God will cleanse you from all unrighteousness. You have to trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not to your own understanding. And all your ways, you must acknowledge him. Because the only way you can be forgiven is God has to direct your path. Some of you are high up. When I say high up, you are in the fivefold ministry. And yes, you did mess up. Yes, you did sleep around. Yes, you did smoke weed. Yes, you did some of things that probably cannot be mentioned on this screen. But God sees it. And so did somebody else. But the idea and the thought of the fact that they can blackmail you or blackball your ministry, I will tell you what. No, they can't. David was smart enough that even though Saul was rejected, he would not put forth his hand to touch God's anointed. He said it was going to come a time where Saul was going to die in the battle. He cut that piece of his garment off. He was just that close. And that blackmailer who thought that they would blackmail you, I'll tell you, Jesus said, upon this rock, I will build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail. If you in sin, come out of sin. Matter of fact, God told me, he said, whatsoever you bind on this earth, Sandra, he said, I will bind it in heaven. Let me tell you, the power to bind it loose rests in the hands and the mouths of God's people who has spent time in the presence of God. You don't get a bind it loose factor unless God can trust you out of my shy with his anointing. God's got to trust you. Not trace you. He's got to trust you. He said, whatever you bind on this earth, Sandra, I'll bind it in heaven. And whatever you loose on earth, I will loose it in heaven. I bind that blackmailing spirit. I command by the blood of Jesus that you don't give nobody a dime. I'd rather for that demonic spirit to be exposed himself than for me to give anybody, God's people, money. Nobody don't got nothing on you. He that touches you, even in your lowest state, touches God. Because that anointing that rests upon your life is there. God said, I have no pleasure in the death of the wicked. If you sin, you have an advocate. Use the advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous. He is the propitiation for our sins. He is the go-between for our sins. He already told you 1,000 shall fall at thy side and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. I want you to know that that follower, that thinking they're going to set you up, they're going to be set up, and the fall will be great. But if you stay in sin, that grace may abound, God forbid. I'd rather repent before a nation of people than to be exposed and lose everything. Hear me in the Holy Ghost. I'd rather repent before a nation of people. They can say what they want. They could leave you. But those who love God and who love you and have the power of God on their life, they will pray you back. They won't let their pastor fall. They won't knock their pastor down. They will not leave you. Those who leave you, they was not for you anyway. And maybe you deserve a new batch of people. Watch, God says, as well as pray. I feel this in the Holy Ghost, and I'm going to say this. Watch your adjutants. Watch the people that are close to you. The person close to you, you will hear people say, I'm going to keep my enemies close to you. That's the most dangerous statement that you can say. Get your enemies away from you. Don't keep them close to you. God said if you dwell in the secret place of the Most High, you will abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Everybody that's assigned to you, I'm speaking in the Holy Ghost. Get a confidentiality agreement this night. And if they don't sign it, they was not for you. There are some people that have to travel with you for the sake of the gospel because you can't drive and kill yourself. But you must protect yourself from those who feel like when I don't like what they're doing, I will leave and I will write a book. God said, watch as well as pray. You ain't going to be able to trust, and I'm sorry I have to say ain't, but you are not for those who are, you know how that is, for those of you who is hearing this word tonight, you better watch as well as pray. Our armor bearer is praying when you don't even know it. An armor bearer is praying down the road. An armor bearer does not sleep in your hotel room because the Bible says, let not your good be evil spoken of. Your armor bearer, if you're a woman, is not a man. Your armor bearer is someone that can be identified, my God, as a true man a woman of God. An armor bearer, if you're a man, is not going to lust after you because you're a man. An armor bearer, if you're a woman, is not going to lust after you because you're a woman. Sometimes people take your kindness for weakness, but you ain't got time to stop on this road to your destiny. To stop and tell somebody that you knew from the beginning had that spirit on them that they can't follow you. And if you have to dismiss them with severance pay. And let them know that, baby, your services are no longer needed, but you have served me well. If they get mad and they want to leave, give them a letter of reference. You better bring it in this hour and know that one of you shall chase 1,000. Two of you shall put 10,000 to flight. If you don't got an armor bearer that don't know how to fast and pray. And I mean, you don't even, if you got to tell your armor bearer, I need you to pray for me. Let me tell you something. Your armor bearer should be anointed enough to lay hands on you. My God, the anointing falls down on the armor bearers. I hope you don't think they just driving. Some of these armor bearers are so anointed they can cast out devils. I felt the anointing of God in that. That's what you need. That's, I feel God on that very strongly. You need an armor bearer that can heal the sick and raise the dead. Look at what Jesus did. He didn't just have anybody following him. He had qualified people to follow him. Watch as well as pray. Keep your eyes open. If you gonna close one, you better leave one open. My God, I'm speaking in this webcam to somebody, and you're saying, my God, I don't know how she know, but the Holy Ghost knows. Get yourself together, because Jesus is coming, and there's new levels. There's new levels of anointing. There's new things in this season that people that thought they knew you, grew up with you, been around you all your life, helped get you where you are. Because don't fool yourself. Some people did help you get where you are in the ministry. But when God gets through with you, I see you. You're a man. You've been laid out before God. You're like, God, do what you want. You're saying, God, do what I see you. You're laying out. You might not be laying out, but I see you. You're a man. You are laying out in the, when I say laying out in the floor, it's like you trying to, you know how you try to start off laying prostrate, but you're the kind of person, you like, God, just roll and do anything you want with me. God, here, I just, God will do it. I know who you are. I even know your name. I won't call your name, but God sees you laying before him. He sees that you're willing to be used by him. See, it's not about who helped you get where you are. It's about the God that's taking you where he wants you to be. I'll tell you, God is moving. Your life is going to change as you know it. I don't know why I see this. I see a theater and I see a floor on the theater. I don't know why I'm seeing this place, but I see a man on the floor. I don't know if your church has a theater type setting or stage, but it was like I see a man on the floor, and I know you by name, and you're just like, you're somebody that'll roll. If God told you to roll, you would roll. As we say, when I say wide open, you're one of the ones that, you know what, whatever God say, if God say jump, you jump. If God say sit, you'll sit. You are the one. I hear the Lord saying, you're the blessed one, because you will hear me. You will acknowledge me. You will even repent to me. God knows who you are and he knows your name. And let me tell you something. He gives those of us who are prophets of God. Now, we ain't playing with this prophetic. The prophetic is nothing to play with. The prophetic is real. The pathetic is a bad thing. But the prophetic is real. And I'll tell you what. It is time to do the will of God. I believe, man of God, I'm going to call you man of God, because you're watching, and it's like she don't know I'm watching, but you're watching, and you are the Joshua. I don't know if you jumped up, but you're the Joshua. God chose you to lead a nation of people. You are the Joshua. I know there's a Moses, but there will be a time Moses will go. And it may be for a time in a seasons and seasons of time, but you have been chosen. I hear the Lord saying, from your mother's womb, from birth, you will lead. Listen, let me say this, how I need to say it. You, through the Spirit of God, God is going to use you to usher in. Now listen, the Bible says, if anybody come from heaven preaching another gospel than that which you have heard, let it be accursed. That's not going to be you. But God is going to use you, man of God, to usher in a new era of holiness where others have dropped their standards. You watching, you see, you look. And let me say this. I'm gonna say this in the Holy Ghost. Let me straighten my hair. And I'm not saying this just to say this, but you're in an inner circle. You're behind the scenes. Yes, God is real, man of God. You're watching me. You're in an inner circle, and you're behind the scenes, and you see things that are not right, and you know they're not right, but out of respect to this man that you're under, you're walking in a humble spirit. And God likes when you're humble. Because you could, by all accounts, just take the thing and run with it. But Joshua was humble. And Moses knew that Joshua was humble. I'm prophetically prophesying to a man of God, and he knows I am talking to him. And while you cannot believe it, because some told you that this woman ain't real, it ain't nothing to her, God told me to tell you that when you dwell in the secret place of the Most High, you will abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I started to cut it, but sometimes you got to keep going and say what thus saith the Lord. You're in the inner circle. You're watching everything. But you don't want to do your ministry like the way people are doing it. You want to come out from among, not the ministry itself that you're under, and be separate. Just some things that you've been noticing that is not right. And you're saying, I can't be like this. But out of respect, I will honor the man of God that I'm under. Let me say this to you. Even the man of God that you're under knows who you are. Many times you will be asked to do things just to see if you still are humble. He already knows you are the Joshua. He already knows you will lead. He already knows that expansion is coming your way. I speak prophetically through this screen that when you humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, that God will exalt you. And when you're laying on the floor and you about to roll, I mean, you just want God to do whatever he wants. I'm telling you, you want God to just have his way. You're drenched in it. You're soaked in it. You just like drenched in God. People think you're crazy and you have lost your mind. But let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus. Oh, yes. Let me tell you something. I believe, God, that the witches can't hex you. I believe, God, that no one that comes out the north, south, east, or west can hex you. I feel God in the name of Jesus. I feel God. When God is with you, the apostolic presence of his anointing is upon you. And let me say this. You can see other people prophesy. You can see other people cast out devils. But you are unique. You have been set apart. You're not going to be like the status quo. You're going to be different, and God is going to use you to usher in a new era. You're going to be the armor bearer. You're going to be the standard bearer. You're going to be somebody. Could you imagine being somebody that God looks down from heaven and say, I can use him, and I don't have to worry about him. I've been through too much. I've been through too much. And when you fought a good fight and you finished your course and you kept the faith, it ain't time to go yet. Some people fought a good fight, finished their course, and kept the faith. He had a choice. He could have stayed here. He had a choice. Sometimes it's for you to go to the next level. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High. When I woke up this morning, I heard surely. I'm going to tell you this. If you ever see a Venus flytrap, I'm going to say this in the Holy Ghost. If you ever see a Venus flytrap and something gets in that flytrap, it traps them in it. When God said, surely I will deliver you from the snare of the fowler, think about the Venus flytrap. If you was in the ocean and you was swimming and you saw this big giant clam and had a pearl in it, and you was like, oh gosh, this pearl is going to be worth millions. And you went, it would clamp down and shut you in. But when God delivers you from the snare of the fowler, it's because the enemy sets a trap up. Now, I'm off talking to the man of God. I'm talking to everybody right now. Let me tell you this. When the enemy feels like I got you, and he got you trapped, anything that stays in a Venus flytrap, it's going to suck the life out of him. Anything that climbs into something that's a trap is going to be ensnared. A spider, a fly can fly in a spider's web, and you know what? That spider, he might not eat them yet. He'll just come down and wrap them up, and he'll go back and wait for the rest of them to come up there. But at the time appointed, he comes in. They can't move, and he comes in for the kill. When God said, surely I shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler, it's because the enemy, and I don't know if somebody is being set up in more ways than one, but when people set a trap for you, the main objective and goal is they're out to kill you. They're out to destroy you. They're out to take your name and put it out for bad. Oh, they are having you for breakfast, lunch, dinner, and they even got you on the appetizer. But the devil is. Surely, God said, I'll deliver you from the snare of the fowler. He think he got you right where he want to. But God says, no, he does not. I'm going to deliver you. It is because of God's mercy that you are not consumed. Great is his faithfulness, Father God. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, and through the power of the Holy Ghost, this word has gone out. It shall not return unto you void. It shall accomplish that which you please and prosper where you have sent it. This is going into the living room, into the houses all across this nation. Let the angels of God walk inside their homes and stand up. You said through this word today that you have given your angels charge over them to keep them in all their ways. God, you watch over the word that you've spoken over their life. You said, my word will not return to me void. It shall accomplish that which I please and prosper where I sent it. My God, you are the living God and the risen Savior. There's many people, God, that know that the word that I spoke has given them a new look on life. God, where they felt like I couldn't come to God because I know I'm messed up, so I just keep on going. They now know there's an entrance back to where they need to be. Somebody wrote a song, I believe Andre Crouch wrote a song, take me back to the place where I first received you. I'd rather go back to the place where I cried out to God for deliverance. My God, in tarrying for the Holy Ghost when we were young, we tarried for the Holy Ghost. Nowadays, people are getting the Holy Ghost on the laying on of hands, but I tell you what you work hard to get, you will work hard to keep. Hold fast to that which thou hast. Let no man take your crown. Father, I pray. You said the prayer of faith shall save the sick. I pray for the sick today. You said, God, you would raise them up, and if they have committed any sins, you will forgive them. Father, there are people listening in this broadcast right now that have the HIV virus in their bodies. They don't want to tell nobody. They have AIDS. They don't want to tell nobody. And God, they're sorry for their sins. I pray for them in the name of Jesus that they will come out from among them and be ye separated. You said this prayer shall save the sick. There will be many that hear this prayer and they will get healed from sicknesses and diseases. But let me tell you this, when God heals you, the Bible says, go and sin no more, lest a worse thing come upon you. The prayer of faith. You were wounded for their transgressions. You were bruised for their iniquities. The chastisement of your peace was upon them now. And by your stripes they are healed. Father, go into the convalescent home in the prisons, where nobody cares about the mothers and fathers that are there. Send your angels, God. Loose your angels into the hallways of every hospital corridor. Jesus' name. The power of the living God. My God, my God, the kingdom of God is come nigh unto you. It's time out for playing games. Remember, this is the house of God. My God, it's time to turn your plate down. You said, I came off a 50-day fast. Well, I ain't never heard of a 50-day fast, and that's it. You've got to make a lifelong commitment, because I'll tell you, many things come through prayer and fasting. My God, not the kind of fasting to promote yourself, but to move forward in the will and in the way of God. When the anointing rests, it is important that we as believers must rest as well. Meaning when the anointing, you know, when you feel the anointing, it's just, I cannot describe it. You would have to be anointed. But you can tell when it, and it lightens on you, and you can tell when it lifts. So at this time, I thank you for watching this broadcast. I want you to know that you are listening to the Georgia God Chasers live at 5 broadcast. We started this broadcast at 5 o'clock, and we will be back, Lord's willing, next Wednesday night at 5 o'clock to 6 o'clock. My God, I started to do it 5 to 5:30. God said, no, don't cut it off. My God, now Sunday mornings, we go 7 o'clock to 7:30 on the Georgia God Chasers channel on live stream live. It's an informal broadcast, but this broadcast, Power Up, it prepares you to walk in the house of God where the anointing of God should be from the pulpit to the door. The Lord has blessed you, and He has graced you to be a part of the move of God. It is not by might, nor is it by power. It is by my spirit, saith the Lord of hosts. If you would like to write me, I want you to address all correspondence to Sandra Wilson Ministries Incorporated, Post Office Box 5252, Alpharetta, Georgia. That zip is 30022. Amen. Next time I come on Sunday, I'm going to give you our Skype number where you can call, you can leave a message, where you can write us and tell us. You can send it to the email at thegeorgiagodchasers@gmail.com. Follow us on Twitter at the Georgia God Chasers. We're now revamping our website. The Google page is Sandra Wilson Ministries. I think I got too many Google pages, but we want to just bring everything down to one page where we do have the Georgia God Chasers page. And so we're revamping all of that. And sometimes in the beginning, you have to do all of that when you don't have no help. But how many of us know you don't despise the day of small beginnings? I'm excited to you and for you. Thank you so much for listening to the Georgia God Chasers. And let me tell you something. Here in Alpharetta, Georgia, we're the Georgia God Chasers. But you can start a chapter in your area. We're going to link up with people all over the world. UK, oh my God, France. We're going to go all over the world because we believe and know that God, if He is for you, He is more than the world against you. As I say every week, go with God, because I'm sure God most certainly will go with you. God bless you.